novel, which is out now, is called The Clay Eaters, and it is about a young boy who loses his father in a hunting accident. He soon discovers that his father, perhaps his death occurred under mysterious circumstances. At the same time, a mysterious trespasser appears on their large property, and this person is on the run. He's a domestic terrorist and a combat veteran. And he befriends the boy and helps him uncover the mystery around his father's death. And there's some dead bodies and some bullets. And Billy is a lost soul. He's a damaged person. And when you read the book, I eventually get to what's caused what motivated him to commit an act of terrorism. And when we meet him, he's again lost and seeking redemption. Jesse is a young man who grows up in a rural area. He idolizes his father and loves to fish and hunt and loves to be outdoors. And when the two meet, it's under the most strenuous of circumstances, but they form a quick and close bond as Jesse, the young boy, realizes that the people in his life are not who they seem, his stepmother and his uncle, and there are forces at play in the town that he lives in, converging on him, and they want to do him harm. And Billy, it opens the door for him to perhaps help this young boy and come to some conclusions about himself. I have a spectrum of bad guy in my book. I like to tell people. So I have the bad guy who you kind of like and sympathize with. You've got the really bad guy you're supposed to hate, and then over here you've got some good people. And then down here are some dead people normally. I take a delight, almost sick delight, in getting convincing a reader to like a person that they normally wouldn't like. Maybe they're reprehensible, maybe they're racist, maybe they've committed a violent act, but they're fragile and sympathetic. And I love when a reader tells me, like, you had me fall in love or sympathize with someone who normally is like, you know, they're bad, they're criminals maybe in some instances. So I enjoy doing that. And I enjoy writing about bad guys. Bad guys with a heart of gold, I guess.